Master Series and Shunt Volt Voltage Regulated Power Supply Trainer Kit. Order code is 36206. So this is the trainer kit. This is the inbuilt DC volt meter, range is 0 to 20 volt, and this is inbuilt DC current meter, range is 0 to 200 milliampere. This is the unregulated DC power supply plus minus 12.5 volt. These are the different types of resistor that is inbuilt. These are the true, there are three transistors. This is one DC108, this is SL100, and this is SSK. This is the Zener diode. These are the different types of resistor. This is 10K potentiometer, this is 1K potentiometer, and this is 500 ohm potentiometer. This part is the load portion. This is the main switch to turn on or off the kit. This is user manual and patch ports. These all are included with this kit. Experiment is to study a transistor shunt voltage regulator with variable current limiting. For this, we are going to build this circuit here that is shown in the manual. Now first connect the positive terminal of the power supply with this resistor 22 ohm. After that, connect the positive terminal of the voltmeter to the load. Now connect the negative terminal of the voltmeter here. Now from this positive terminal of the power supply, connect this resistor 390 ohm and connect the other terminal of this resistor to this Zener. Now connect again the cathode of the diode with this capacitor. Connect the negative terminal here at this point. Now connect. Now after that, connect the emitter of the transistor here at this potentiometer, 1K potentiometer. Again from this terminal of the potentiometer, connect the positive terminal of the current meter. Now connect the negative terminal of the current meter here at the load. From this collector of the transistor, connect this terminal of the load, and from the base of this transistor, connect this Zener diode. After that, keep this knob at fully anti-clockwise position. Keep this knob at fully anti-clockwise position and keep this knob at fully clockwise position. Now turn on the kit, this, and slowly increase the current using this knob. We can see this is the output current, that is 8.2 milliampere. Beyond this, the current cannot be increased. Now again, bring it back to the fully anti-clockwise position and slowly move this toward anti-clockwise position like this. Now again, increase the, now again, rotate it to clockwise position. And we can see that the output current is slightly increased, that is 8.7. Like this, again bring it back to the initial position and move it towards anti-clockwise position. Let's keep it here. Now again increase this, and we can see the limiting current amount is increased. Now it is 13.9, that is almost 14 milliampere current. Experiment is to study a transistor shunt voltage regulator with fixed current limiting. For this, we are going to use this circuit diagram here that is given in the manual. So first, connect the positive terminal of this power supply to this resistor. Now Connect the positive terminal of the voltmeter here at the load. Connect the negative terminal of the voltmeter to the other terminal of the load. Now, from this load, connect the negative terminal of the current meter and connect the positive terminal of the current meter here at this terminal of the resistor, 220 ohm. Now, connect this with the emitter of the transistor and connect the collector of the transistor here. Now, connect the base of the transistor to the cathode of the Zener diode. Connect the Zener diode with this 100 microfarad capacitor. And now connect this resistor 390 ohm again to the cathode of the Zener diode. Now connect the negative terminal of the power supply with this terminal of the resistor and connect this terminal of the 390 ohm resistor to the positive terminal of the power supply. Now turn on the kit. This is in no load position. Now slowly move the potentiometer knob, this 500 ohm potentiometer knob, and adjust the output current to 20 milliampere. We will see that as we adjust it to 20 milliampere, the output voltage changed from no load to full load of 20 milliampere. This voltage is the voltage of Zener diode plus the voltage drop across this transistor. Experiment is to set up for studying a transistor shunt variable voltage regulator with fixed current limiting. For this, we are going to build this circuit diagram here. The circuit diagram is almost same like the previous experiment, only we will connect the base of the transistor here at this 10k potentiometer, this middle, at the middle terminal of the 10k potentiometer, and connect this terminal of the potentiometer to the cathode of the Zener diode. Now keep this to fully anti-clockwise position, this 500 ohm potentiometer. Turn on the kit and with the help of this 10k potentiometer we can vary the voltage from 0 to 6 like this. Next experiment is study of a transistor series voltage regulator with fixed current limiting. For this, we are going to build this circuit diagram here. So first, connect this point with the transistor. Now connect the positive terminal of the voltmeter here with the load. Connect the negative terminal here like this. Now connect this emitter of the transistor to this resistor 4K7, and from here we will connect the positive terminal of the current meter. Now connect the base of the transistor with the Zener diode at this point. Now from this, connect this capacitor 100 microfarad, and from this capacitor we will connect this resistor 390 ohm. From this, again from this terminal, we will connect this transistor BC108. Connect this terminal of the resistor with the negative, connect this terminal of the resistor here with the positive terminal of the power supply. from the negative terminal of the power supply, connect this resistor 15 ohm. Now connect the base of the transistor with this resistor 47 ohm. After that, keep this potentiometer at fully anticlockwise position, and now turn on the kit and we will perform the experiment. Keep this 500 ohm potentiometer to fully anticlockwise position. Now turn on the kit. After that, slowly increase the current. Keep increasing the current. At certain point, we will see that the current limiting point is reached. When the current limiting point is reached, the output current may decrease slightly. Here we can see that the output current has decreased slightly. Now keep increasing the load. And we can see that has shoot up suddenly, but this current will be limited.